pirate history is and will likely always be full of gaps. That is why, when I started looking for actual historical pirate flags, I found out that the information we have gathered about them is not nearly as secure and convincing as I'd assumed. Here's what we know. The iconic Jolly Roger was never the pirate flag. People have called many, somewhat different flags by that name. The clear distinction of the Jolly Roger as a black flag with a skull on it came only much later. Pirates flew all kinds of different colors and designs, or just used the naval ensigns from the places they came from, since national flags weren't much of a thing back then. The reason for using flags on a ship in the first place was to signal to others who the people on that ship were. You see the Jolly Roger, you know they're pirates. In times before Morse code was invented, ships at sea basically had the choice between yelling really loudly and hoping for the best, or flying flags to communicate with each other. Flags gave you an idea whether an approaching ship carried friend or foe, which, of course, could easily be exploited by pirates for surprise attacks. That system of using flags to communicate at sea, which in a more codified form is still used today, could also be used for slightly more intricate messages that went beyond "We are pirates." Pirates sometimes used a red flag in addition to their usual flags to indicate no quarter to their victims, making it clear that no prisoners will be taken. A person well versed in the impressive variety of pirate flags could easily read a design to tell you which captain had command over a certain ship or fleet, since they were basically used as business cards of pirate captains, each different from the next. But it was also not uncommon for a captain to abandon one design for a new one multiple times in the course of his career. If one is interested in that kind of thing and wants to actually take a look at the flags used by different pirates, it's fairly easy to go online and do so, with one caveat. You can find lots and lots of pirate flags on the internet, but many of them have no basis in history. They've been made up after the fact. But keeping those aside, even the historical pirate flags we can lay our eyes upon today are only illustrations based on descriptions or paintings. As far as I know, there is no single physical pirate flag preserved from the period commonly known as the Golden Age of Piracy. Probably because people back then didn't care too much about preserving the legacy of armed robbers and murderers. I did find one picture of a flag from somewhere between 1718 and 21 on the shop page of the National Maritime Museum in London of all places, but even that looks more like a scan of an illustration in some book, and the museum's online catalogue of its collection does not feature a flag like that. Other than that, I only found a flag chart from a book on pirates from 1922, which is inconclusive evidence at best, and two objects, one that could be a flag, but is more likely a shrine hanging from a pirate ship, dated 1849, and a Chinese army flag from around 1926, found on a pirate ship that was likely used as false colors. And that's all I could come up with. So, replicas are the closest we can get to how pirate flags actually looked. But descriptions can vary considerably in their respect for detail, and even period paintings carry with them some doubt about how much of them is artistic license and how much is grounded in fact. That is not to say that the flags you can look up on Wikipedia are not real pirate flags. Many of them were most certainly used at some point in history. Only it's worthwhile to mention that what you see is the artistic impression of a pirate flag, not the flag how it truly looked, down to the last detail. But the internet being the internet, just takes the information it is given from all the possible places, slaps a watermark on there, and calls it the real thing. It's especially entertaining to me that stock image sites host loads and loads of these pirate flags, often with filters and textures of wood or cloth on them, to make them look more gritty and realistic, like a photo of a real, physical flag. Only, it's not a real flag. It's an Inkscape illustration someone took from Wikipedia and put on there. Those same base images are also grabbed by more or less dodgy-seeming flag online shops, who will satisfy your every pirate flag need, historical accuracy not included. If you, in your role as good internet citizen, then tried to track down the pirate flags on Wikipedia, which is what so many other informational websites feed their flag charts with, conveniently forgetting to credit their source by the way, you get two things. References to the Polish Wikipedia, where many were presumably first uploaded, and links to an open clip art library. Now, I don't know about you, but while I do trust the esteemed officials of the unshakable institution that is openclipart.org, I don't trust them quite enough to take their word that these anonymously uploaded images are what pirate flags actually looked like. To put this in perspective, most of the flags on Wikipedia are images created by Wikipedians, so these pirate flags are nothing special. However, Most official or historical flags on Wikipedia are based on a reliable source that specifies how the flag should be constructed in detail or on a photograph of a preserved physical flag. In best cases, they're based on both. But for these pirate flags, neither is available, so we can only attempt to reproduce them based on the limited information available. And these reproductions, provided we remember that they are nothing more than that, are still much better than having no pirate flags to look at all.